play some Fallout 3. I played New Vegas before, but that's the only one I would play. And 4 just came out, so I figured, you know, maybe I should finally play 3. Let's go.
I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart I have but one desire, and that one is you, no other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love, and with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of. Be clean. I don't set the world on fire.
War. War never changes. Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything from God to justice to simple psychotic rage. In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself no longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation. But it was not, as some had predicted, the end of the world. Instead, the apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history. For man had succeeded in destroying the world, but war never changes. In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as vaults. But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them. All except those in Vault 101. For on that fateful day, when fire rained from the sky, the giant steel door of Vault 101 slid closed and never reopened. It was here you were born. It is here you will die. Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters, and no one ever leaves.
Doctor.
It's a girl? A girl. We've got a daughter, Catherine. A beautiful, healthy baby girl.
Oh. Oh, I guess it's
my daughter. James. We did it. Oh, the daughter. Oh, our beautiful daughter.
You've got a bright future ahead of you, sweetie. I'm sure of it. Look at you. Look at you. Hi there. I'm your daddy, sweetheart. Daddy. You're going to need a name, aren't you? Your mother and I have been talking. What do you think about...
I'm gonna just pick my own name. Being a baby and all. Why not? Why not be character name?
That's a good name, don't you think? Fits you perfectly. Looks like they've finished the gene projection. Let's see what you'll look like when you're all grown up.
That's interesting. I can go back on my words. Maybe I'll be Hispanic. But of course you knew. I'm a preset kind of person. Whoa. Well, for face, but...
like your dad. See that, Catherine?
Oh. Oh, beautiful. Just like her daddy.
It's a big world out there, honey, full of all sorts of people. What about you? What kind of person are you going to be? You're just
James?
Catherine?
James?
Catherine! She's in cardiac arrest. Start compressions. Get the baby out of here. Move! Move! 1,000.
Oh, my
two,
dad is a doctor.
Come on. Hang on, Catherine. Hang on. Okay?
You one. We need a doctor, not a dead man. This one's on the house. Fail to meet my expectations, and there will be
no. Don't look straight into the
James and his cheery chatter.
Decorations.
May your future be bright, boys.
Something this place will feel just like home. Come on over here, sweetie. Come on. Walk to daddy.
Whoa, I'm moving kind of fast for a baby.
You can do it.
Can't look at my legs.
Over here.
Bye.
Come to daddy. Just a little further. There you go. My goodness, just a year old and already walking like a pro. Your mother would have been so proud. Listen, kiddo, I know you don't like it when Daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of yourself for a minute. You just stay here while Daddy runs to his office. You'll be okay, honey. I'll be back in a bit.
Yes. I, a one-year-old, will take care of myself. As one-year-olds are prone to do. This doesn't look like a place for a baby. Oh, okay, that's why I'm walking so fast. There we go. Head caps on. You're special. Oh. This is cool. That's cool. That's cool. That's cool. Baby who can jump. No, I'm in here. Can I crouch yet? No. Oh. Oh, you're back already.
You are quite the little explorer, aren't you? Serves me right for trying to pin you in.
You'll never catch me, Dad.
Come on over here. I want to show you something.
No.
See that?
What?
It was your mother's favorite passage.
What?
It's from the Bible. Revelation 21:6.
I have to go
talk
to you.
I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. She always loved that. All right, come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amada wants to play.
Mama. Oh. I can just make these sounds. Mama. Gurgle with E. Dad, I don't know if you realize this, but I have hella agility for a 1-year-old. You just let your 1-year-old walk behind you normally?
These experiments
don't
are
damn fool. We experiment to prepare. We prepare to survive.
Surprise!
Stanley, you turned the lights on too fast. You blinded the poor kid.
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday!
Can you believe it? She is growing up so fast.
Happy birthday, honey. I can't believe you're already 10. I'm so proud of you. If only your
mother... Congratulations, young lady. I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I? Down here in Vault 101, when you turn 10, well, you're ready to take on your first official Vault responsibilities. So here you are. As overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000.
Yeah.
Get used to it.
Oh.
You'll be getting your first work assignment tomorrow.
Enjoy your party. You're only 10 once, so have fun.
Oh man, you got a Pip-Boy. I wish I was 10.
Happy birthday!
Oh, no.
We really surprised you, didn't we? Your dad was afraid you were onto us. But I told him not to worry. You're so easy to fool.
If I could see you in the face, I'd punch you in it.
You're welcome. But really, your dad did most of it. I just helped with the decorations and stuff. Hey, I bet you can't guess what I got you for your birthday. Go on, guess.
My dad's armpit?
Gross! I didn't think you even liked boys. Especially not Freddy the Freak. Yuck. I guess maybe I should give this to someone else. Someone who'd rather curl up with Grognak the Barbarian than Freddy Gomez. The question is, how could you tell the difference?
Thanks. Whatever your name was.
Hey, you having a nice time? Happy birthday, Missy.
Come here often. Oh, yeah, I was trying to do that earlier. Looks just like it did in New Vegas. Enjoy the party.
Nice party.
I hope you appreciate the effort Amada put into this party. She really seems to like you, for some reason.
Oh, well. Lesser of two evils.
That's not what I hear. But perhaps she'll set a good example for you. There's still plenty of time for you to make something of yourself.
Whoa. Asshole.
Enjoying yourself?
Amada's not even 10. Tickle.
Attention, everyone! It's time to cut the cake!
Oh.
Andy, wait!
Hey,
Happy birthday, nosebleed.
Oh, no.
How's it going, sweetheart?
Allow me to wish you a happy birthday.
I don't kill you.
I would offer you a piece of cake, but I am mortified
about
it.
What do you think we should call our guests?
I know you were joking, but I'm not sure anyone else did.
Having a good time?
Who wants to go around all day?
It wasn't easy keeping this a secret. Now go on. I'm sure everyone else would like a chance to talk to the both of you.
How do you like that there Pip-Boy, miss? Fit all right and everything? As a matter of fact, I did. I'm glad you like it. Some may think the A-Series a bit basic, but I've always preferred them for their reliability. Don't mention it. Oh, yes, I almost forgot. Happy birthday! Not much, but I hope you like it.
Yeah, if you were hoping I was gonna play this as an asshole, I don't play games as assholes. I'll try in my second run.
You think he surprised her?
I'm sure
normally,
that I'm not. Never suspected a thing.
Like I tried with Mass Effect.
Now go on and enjoy yourself.
I get really uninterested when I have
to be. What
are
you looking at?
Thanks for coming, Stanley.
Shut up.
Are you having a nice party? 10 years old. My. Seems like only yesterday that your daddy came. Goodness, listen to me ramble. You're waiting for your present, aren't you? Fiddlesticks! What 10-year-old doesn't like presents? I was 10 once, believe it or not. My goodness, the vault was practically crowded back then. Not like today. So few young people now. But here I am rambling on again, and you listening so politely. Here you go. A nice sweet roll that I baked for you just this morning. And it's all for you. No sharing required today.
I know you were busy with the water purifier. Everything's fine, I hope.
Thanks, lady.
Oh, sure, nothing to worry.
Whoa. I'm hungry, and that stupid robot destroyed the cake. Give me that sweet roll you got from old Lady Palmer.
I've seen this. No. I hate you, Butch.
Oh, yeah? We'll see about that.
Are we gonna fight?
Happy birthday.
I'm sorry.
Stuff again last night. Good as new.
Say, Uncle.
How do I fight?
Butch, what are you doing?
How do I fight? 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 How do I fight?
Well, at least it doesn't have your name in it somewhere. Which makes it better than any of your other ideas.
What's Butch's problem, anyway? I can't believe he tried to start a fight at your own birthday party. What a jerk!
Yeah, and it wouldn't let me punch him back.
God, he really is a butthead. Oh well, you can always count on Butch to make an ass of himself. Get it?
You are not 10 yet.
Hello, Officer Gomez. I'm glad you could make it.
I didn't bring you
up. I'm glad to be here.
You're gonna be really sorry you messed up.
It's important to keep in touch with the young people, you know, as part of my job.
Thanks. I'll send her right down. How's it going, sweetheart?
Sure thing, Officer Gomez.
Are you talking about me?
Well, it's been nice
chatting
with
you. Dad, are you talking about me?
Hey, that was Jonas on the intercom. He and I have been cooking up a little surprise present. Jonas is waiting for you downstairs on the reactor level. Go ahead. I don't think anyone will mind if you slip out for a few minutes.
Thanks again
for coming.
I thought
you wanted me to talk to all these asses. I don't like you, Paul.
Hey, thanks for inviting me. Really cool party and everything.
Oh,
I know
like you,
that,
Paul.
Butch and I give you a hard time, but you don't take that seriously, right? Anyway, happy birthday and everything. I better get back to, you know.
What? Is she your best friend now? Hey, Wally, I think Paul's in love.
Yeah, Paul. Why don't you introduce
Enjoying
us to your
yourself?
New girlfriend?
Oh, man.
Happy birthday, dearie. My goodness, I hope I didn't miss the party.
Who are you?
They sure did. My. 10 years old already? Why, I can remember helping your dad change your diapers. And now look at you, a great big grown-up 10-year-old with your very own Pip-Boy. Since this was such a special occasion, do you know what I did? I wrote you a poem just for you. I hope you like it.
I really want to say that. Thanks, Beatrice. Beatrice.
Of course. Run along now, dearie, and have yourself a wonderful birthday.
Who do you mean, Dorkface here? Happy birthday, Dorkface.
Thank you for coming, Miss Beatrice. I hope you're having a nice time.
Whoa.
Oh my goodness.
I just wanted to see if I had purple hair in youth. World.
That dear girl is like a daughter to me.
No. Zoom in.
Sorry about Butch.
No.
Your dad said we had to invite
him.
Happy birthday,
come on, you guys can do better than that.
This party's pretty good, I guess. For a little kid. Balloons, party hats. Not as cool as my party, though. Remember how my dad got Andy to do magic tricks? And we all played Hunt the Mutant in the atrium? Oh, right. You weren't invited to my party. Too bad, man. It was really fun.
A good name.
Paul? Paul wasn't. Paul, you'll live.
The Watkins?
Can I save yet? I can't save yet?
Paul, you really are as dumb as you look, aren't you? Sounds like a washing machine or something.
Hey, leave Paul alone. That baseball bat isn't a weapon. Oh, I thought it was a bat. It's just a cap. I'm gonna wear this. You can't say anything.
Snakes are cool, right? Bald snakes. What do you guys think?
Ugh.
I don't know.
Dad, I hate my friends. They're all assholes.
Well, I don't know.
Where?
I've got
Reactor?
To think about it.
Is that what you said?
Just be patient. You don't want to ruin the surprise, do you?
Yes.
Go ahead. Jonas is waiting.
And my favorite part of New Vegas was exploring the vaults. Some of them were creepy. Yo.
What are you doing down here, young lady? I thought kids weren't allowed down on the reactor level.
I'm 10, asshole.
You sure are. Pip-Boy and everything. Look at that. If you can wait just one more minute, I think your dad will want to give you the surprise himself.
Wait, if we can't take these off, how do you get your coat on? Jonas? Get away from me, Dad.
Are you ready for your surprise?
I don't like surprises.
The Overseer gave you your Pip-Boy, and you're old enough to do some work, so... I figure you're old enough for this. Your own BB gun. It's a little old, but it should work perfectly. Jonas found it down here. It was in pretty rough shape. Took us a good 3 months to find the parts to get it working again. You know how tough it is to find a spring that small? Good thing Butch misplaced that switchblade of his. So, what do you think?
Good.
Want to give it a try?
Have a weapon. I don't want to do.
We sure can't.
Ouch. I missed what you said. Oh, is that a range? Is it, Dad? I need to get this stuff out of the way so I stop accidentally clicking. Wait. So I do or don't have it equipped right now? Do or don't. That means it's equipped, right? Okay. I'm gonna kill you. Can I save now? Thank God. Alright, I'm gonna shoot that kid in the face. I bet that's why they let you save then. So you can go shoot that kid in the face. Damn it. I'm gonna get you. How do I put this weapon away? Is it R? Yeah. Ooh, muscle memory. I'm impressed with myself. So,
well, what do you think? You can come down here and shoot anytime you want.
By the reactor?
Couldn't have done it without Jonas's help. You make sure to thank him.
This is Jonas.
Happy birthday, darling. I hope you have fun with it. Hey, you don't turn 10 every day. Now go on and let me see you shoot something.
But I hit that one.
Careful, it's a rad roach. Think you can take care of that with your BB gun?
Where?
Just aim and shoot. What? You'll be fine.
Damn it, there's still stuff in the way. I keep clicking by accident. Okay. Mobile. Where? Where? I didn't hit him. But I still didn't hit him. Oh god, I'm having a flashback. What is it, V? Yeah. This is such a great game. Bye.
Good work. That's one less rat roach to deal with. Let's get a picture together. Capture the moment. Hey, Jonas, get a picture of me with a big game hunter.
No, I don't wanna. I don't wanna. Wait. Oh. Never mind.
Smile!
Boys and girls have different parts.
What is your problem? I'm the overseer's daughter, so what? That like, I get any kind of special treatment.
Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. As far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old girl. So, yes, you have to go to class to take your goat exam. Go on now. You've got a goat to take.
I'll take that goat.
The Generalized Occupational Aptitude Test. Goat. Everyone here in the vault takes it when they're 16. Helps to figure out what sort of a job you'll have here in Vault 101 when you get a bit older. So, pay attention and try not to fall asleep. You know what the overseer says? We're born in the vault, we die in the vault.
That's not fun.
Each is tested to determine their abilities, that they may work for the betterment of all vault residents. Huh. Sound familiar?
No, I never heard it.
That's not the way it works. And it won't do to go around asking questions like that. Especially not around the overseer. I want to tell you something now. It's important, so listen closely. This place, this vault, it's not perfect, I know. But it is your home. You're safe here. Stay on the overseer's good side, and you always will be. You understand? You need to appreciate all you have. Because what's up there, on the outside, that's not the life I want for you. And it's not what your mother wanted for you either.
Sucks, Dad.
That's what the overseer says, isn't it? He's not about to let anyone else in, so I guess that's how it'll have to be. You're here now, and it's a hell of a lot better than being up there. All your mother and I ever wanted was for you to be safe, and you're safe here. Your mother, she was beautiful. But beyond the beauty you've seen. There's just so much those old photos can never show. And she was passionate. About life, about love. But most of all she was passionate about you. When she became pregnant, it was the happiest I had ever seen her. Ah, she had great things in mind for you. And so, time for you to stop stalling and get to class. Please, honey, please, take these achievement tests seriously. The last thing I need is your mother's ghost haunting me because her only child became a garbage burner.
I guess he wouldn't love me if I was a garbage burner, huh?
Hey, it's not my call. Those are the rules. You're 16 now, so this year you take the goat. Come on, it's not so bad. Everyone has to take it. You'll do just fine. Take care, sweetie. I got out of here, and good luck.
Do I still have my BB gun? That's all I care about. Oh. Not even my sweet roll for 6 years. ready. Just scan that, but oh, I shouldn't have scanned it. I should actually read it. I'm already kind of creeped out by this. It's usually a sign of abuse. He ducked for cover or something. He did not. Oh. Cool.
Good morning. Stopped in to see the old man before class,
I didn't want to auto-walk. How do I pick stuff up?
Morning, Jonas.
Morning, Doc.
Oh, hey.
How's things?
Hey. Have you had a chance to look over these results?
I was just going over them.
I'd just like to keep an eye on it.
No problem. I'll have my report ready this afternoon.
Sounds good. Let me know if there are any...
Good luck with the goat, cutie.
Oh, don't call me that. Hee-hee. What was there called? Hey, hey. Something tells me I'm about to leave the vault.
Hi, Stanley.
Step back.
Sorry to keep you waiting. What seems to be the trouble today?
Step back.
I've got this headache that just won't go away. Even with the pills you gave me last week. It's the lights, I think. They hurt my eyes.
That's still bothering
me. I'm gonna leave at 16.
Well, I can run a few more tests if you like.
Yes, I think I'd like that.
My way, you stupid tunnel snakes.
I'm a little worried. I hope Jonas can take a look at me soon.
Stanley. You're going to die, Stanley. Daddy's girl, daddy's. Who's saying that? I'll kill him.
Back off, Butch.
Oh, it's Amata. And Butch. Hey.
What is it now, man?
Hey.
She thinks she's better than us.
Can I start a fight?
Man. Daddy's girl's in a cry.
Butch, stop it! Leave her alone!
Teach you to mess up the tunnel,
snake. This isn't
solving
anything!
Come on, tunnels.
Okay, okay. You win. We'll leave the little girl alone.
Oh my God.
You're not worth our time anyway.
That's great.
Come on, tunnel snakes. We're out of here.
I started flinging my fist around.
Whatever you say, Butch. You're the boss. Tunnel snakes rule.
Fine, let's go.
What do you want, nerd?
You were supposed to be cool, Paul. You were supposed to be cool.
Hey.
Thanks for getting rid of them.
There's blood everywhere.
I don't know why they won't leave me alone. Just because my father's the overseer, I guess? Idiots.
Hey, Susie, what's new?
Oh, not much. Our heater's on the fritz again.
You're kidding me.
Guess I
didn't you just
take
get new
goat.
Parts for it last week?
Yeah, sure did.
Oh, this doesn't let me select from the beginning if I want to do the survival.
Well, you made it.
Oh, hello.
All set for the goat? Trust me, it really isn't that bad. Just something everybody has to go through.
Anyway, as I was trying to say, I don't like doing the survival strategy. It just kind of stresses me out. Anyway, I'm sure they'll give me an option once I actually get down there.
I'm sure you will, especially since it's multiple choice with no wrong answers.
Whatever.
We'll start as soon as everyone's found a seat. Good luck. Take your seat so we can get started.
Oh, I can't bring the fist
out. I've got other things to do.
I'll kill you, Butch.
We'll talk to your little friend later.
Thanks for getting rid of them. Assholes. I don't know.
No, I already talked to you, Ahmad.
Back off.
You again. What did I tell you about talking to me, huh? I don't want to catch a case of the nerd from you.
Oh, we're never going to be friends. Why are you talking to me?
Why are you guys saying that?
Go ahead, take a seat so we can start.
I just wanted to be weird.
Well, now that everyone has managed to find the classroom, we can finally get started. No talking, and keep your eyes to yourselves. Yes, I'm talking to you, Mr. Deloria.
Sure thing, Mr. Brotch.
Unless anyone else has an insightful comment, let's get started. Question one. A frenzied vault scientist runs up to you and yells, I'm going to put my quantum harmonizer in your photonic resonation chamber. What's your response?
I probably would fight him, yes.
Question two. While working as an intern in the clinic, a patient with a strange infection in his foot stumbles through the door. The infection is spreading at an alarming rate, but the doctor has stepped out for a while. What do you do? Question three. You discover a young boy lost in the lower levels of the vault. He's hungry and frightened, but also appears to be in possession of stolen property. What do you do? Question 4. Congratulations. You've made one of the Vault 101 baseball teams. Which position do you prefer?
Is there enough room for that?
Question 5. Your grandmother invites you to tea.
Oh my god.
But you're surprised when she gives you a pistol and orders you to kill another vault resident. What do you do?
Oh, I thought this was about assisted suicide. I'm a little messed up.
Question 6. Old Mr. Abernathy has locked himself in his quarters again, and you've been ordered to get him out. How do you proceed?
This is really messed up stuff they probably have had to deal with.
Question 7. Oh no! You've been exposed to radiation, and a mutated hand has grown out of your stomach. What's the best course of treatment? Question 8. A fellow Vault 101 resident is in possession of a Grognak the Barbarian comic book, issue number 1. You want it. What's the best way to obtain it?
I already have it.
Question 9. You decide it would be fun to play a prank on your father. You enter his private restroom when no one is looking and...
Oh my god. This is the only thing that won't hurt him.
Question 10. Who is indisputably the most important person involved 101?
Is it the OSC?
He who shelters us from the harshness of the atomic wasteland, and to whom we owe everything we have, including our lives.
It's gonna be me, bitch.
Pencils down, people. That's it. The infamous goat. I'm sure most of you didn't find it so bad. Others, well, there are always openings in the maintenance department. Don't forget to hand in your test before you leave. You don't want to know what happens to people who fail the goat. You can have the rest of the day off to celebrate or to pray, as the situation warrants.
Can I beat somebody up now? I can't. I can't move. Oh. What's going on? I can't move forward.
Get out of my face.
Here you are, Mr. Broch.
We'll talk to your little friend later.
Nothing to worry about, Miss Almodovar. Let's see.
Very well done. My stuff's all messed up.
Looks like it's the supervisory track for you.
There we go. The safe fixed it.
See you tomorrow.
The hell?
Yo, Teach!
I'm done!
You again. What did I tell you about talking to me, huh?
Can I?
I don't want to catch a case of the nerd from you.
Long
Paul, you're better
time.
Than this. Paul!
Allow me. I'm thinking of going with Overseer for the last one. Yeah, what did you put?
Leave me alone, you little spaz.
Right now, I don't pay any attention to you.
Hi.
You really
want
to keep it that way, okay?
You surprised me, Butch. I didn't think you had it in you. Hairdresser. What a thunk it.
You're so full of it. That isn't true.
All finished?
I'm all done, Mr. Broch. I guess. Wait a second. Can I have it back? I think I need to change one of my answers.
Just calm down a minute, Paul. I'm sure you have nothing to worry about. Let's see. Yep, just as I thought. You're slated for the engineering track. Congratulations, Mr. Hannon. You've passed the goat.
Oh, gee. That's not so bad. Engineering, all right.
All finished?
It's weird that you can pass or
Snake.
Not pass.
Looks like the diner's going to get a new fry cook. I'll just say this once. Hold the mustard, extra pickles.
You're shitting me, right?
Listen, I was just as obnoxious at your age. I didn't take the goat seriously. And look where I ended up. Just between you and me, the whole test is a joke. If you don't like the results, I can make your goat come out any way you want. Just let me know.
Oh, look at that. Also, I don't like that you said you were obnoxious at my age, just like me. What? I don't... take that back. Love me some lockpick. I like small guns. I like sneaking too. Ooh, energy weapons. I like stealing.
Life forever.
So what I get?
Surely you have someplace better to be than hanging around my classroom.
Now can I use my
Hello.
Fist?
Back off.
How do you want Susie Mac? Hate you. Trying to get so far away.
What's this type of
See you tomorrow, my
friend.
Even an A.
That is Mr. Brock right here to save you now.
Is he?
Back to work.
Selfish and insubordinate.
Wake up! Come
you
on,
need to
wake
know
up!
These things. I'm not going to be around to hold your hand.